Hi there, Magnus here. I want to show you the mods that we have for Synplant 2. Maybe you know that we have script functionality in Microtonic, and we have this in Synplant as well. But we also have something we call mods. They're located here in the scripts folder under the mods folder. And they're basically like scripts that are loaded automatically into Synplant when it starts, and they add or change user interface functions. You know, it's a way for us to add things and change things in Synplant without having to recompile all of it from scratch, which takes a long time, and then we have to test everything, etc., etc. So I want to show you the four mods that we have as of today. These are favorite button, tween branches, graft patch onto branch, and detail DNA hints. So let's start off with the favorite button. As you may notice, we have a little heart up here in the patch display. You simply click on it to mark a patch as a favorite patch. And what it does is that it copies that patch into a favorite folder under your user patches folder. So for example, if you load something here, like that one, this one. Okay, now we favorited this. I can right click, and then we have the favorite patches here. We can also show the favorite patch folder. And if you load anything, you will be in the favorite patch folder, so then you will be browsing your favorites. So next mod, Tween Branches. Tween Branches is a menu item that gets added to this menu when you right-click the plant. And it's especially useful for the velocity bulb mode and the ranges bulb mode. Let me load something different here. Let's go with this one. So here we have a sound that changes when the branch length changes. Let's say we want to have the velocity change the sound this way. Then we go to the velocity bulb mode. The lowest velocity is here, 10. The highest is here, 127. Let's say we want to have like that sound at the highest and this here. Then we do right click, tween branches, and it will make a nice spirally shape so that the harder you play, you know, the shorter the branch is. But maybe it's a little too insensitive now, so let's put that there, and then we do tween branches, and then you see it morphs from there to there and from there to there. So that's tween branches. Next up, the detailed DNA hints. Inside the DNA editor, when you hover above a knob, you see a pop-up hint. But without this mod, you would only see the number that goes from 0 to 1, in this case 0.1638. With this mod, you get the extra descriptive text there, so you can actually see that now the key follow is exactly 100 there. Well, not exactly, but almost 100. Exactly 100. Useful for, you know, finding the right pitch of oscillator B, for example. Also works in if we turn on tempo sync. Let's make it a little more interesting. Like this, maybe. Okay, and then we turn on tempo sync. And you get to see the rate here on all the parameters that are synced. It's like this one, the info rate, even the sample and hold here, when it goes really high here, it gets synced. So just makes everything a little easier when you're inside the DNA editor. And finally, we have the coolest mod, which is the grafting mod. It adds items to this context menu, just like the tween mod. The items are copy branch and graft onto branch, and they allow you to copy a sound from one branch and paste them onto another. And it can be in the same patch or into a completely different patch. So you can, you know, copy sounds from different patches and put them all together into one plant and play them on the different branches with the different keys on your keyboard, etc. You could use it in layered mode to create layered patches, or in like the standard mode to make, for example, a drum kit. So let's try that out. I will load these patches here. Some patches that I made with Yeno Patch from samples from the Yamaha, famous Yamaha FM circuit, the OPL circuit. So let's take the snare, for example. And I copy that branch and I go to the kick. I will paste it here on this branch. I have to extract the branch a little first, and I will tell you why soon. And then I graft onto that branch. And then we have the snare there. And let's go to the hi-hat. I'll copy the hi-hat. Like that. Copy branch. Now I go back here with the undo button. But of course, I could have two instances of Synplant open and, you know, switch between them that way. And let's put that one there, graft onto branch. And then we have a simple drum kit. And the reason I need to extract the branch first before I graft it is that it's actually morphing the sound from the seed sound, the kick in this case, into the patch that I just grafted. So that's another use case. You can use it to morph between two different sounds this way. Let's make a layered patch too, where we stack two different patches into one patch. We'll right click my favorite button, and then let's see, we will combine this one with this one perhaps. So let's take this one first. I'll copy that. Had this, we go to layered mode, and I will put it up here. I will graft there. And now I have layered those two different patches into the same sound. So that's what I had to show you today. I hope you like these mods. They're free to download for everyone that owns Synplant 2, and I will provide a link in the description where to find it. And that's it.